So we have a lot to discuss concerning your committee's investigations. But first, I want to ask you about CNN's new reporting. You just heard it at the top of the hour. How concerned are you that the Attorney General Jeff Sessions omitted mentioning his meetings with the Russian ambassador on his application for a security clearance?
Well, look, I haven't seen the application. I don't know what's required, whether incidental contact at, say, a convention or something is required. And it really is an issue for the United States Senate. I mean, they're the ones that go through the confirmation process, and you would hope that anybody who fills out those forms give it completely, truthfully, and fulfills the obligation that they're due.
Your committee, the House Oversight Committee, set today as a deadline, Mr. Chairman, for the FBI to supply any of former FBI Director Comey's memos on his conversations with President Trump. Have you received those memos?
No. In fact, we got a communication yesterday, an email, just two lines, basically telling us that they would not provide those documents given the fact that there was a special counsel now in place. I also spoke with the FBI director, Mr. Comey, a day before yesterday. We had a one-on-one conversation, and I know he also spoke with Elijah Cummings as well. And he and I, Elijah Cummings and I, my ranking member, the Democrat on our committee, we compared notes. Mr. Comey did not want to come testify publicly because of the presence of a special counsel. Didn't cut it off saying he would never come. He just said that he wanted to speak with Mr. Mueller before committing to any sort of public testimony. That seemed to make sense to me, and I hope it's fair to represent that Mr. Cummings understood that as well. I hope that's a fair representation. The other thing is, we want to see the documents. We believe Congress has a role to play, but we also don't want to impede an investigation by the special counsel. So we're trying to find our way here without impeding what the special counsel is trying to do.
Did Comey tell you he wrote those contemporaneous memos of his conversations with the president?
No, he didn't. In fact, I said we have heard reports about these documents. Are they at the Department of Justice, or are they with him personally? Because remember, even the New York Times reporter who put this stuff, the original story out there, nobody's actually seen these documents. We're assuming that they're there, but I haven't seen that they're there. And so I'm skeptical and want to see them ourselves. But Director Comey he would not answer that question. He would not confirm where they are, what their presence, if there was a presence of these documents, he would not say a word about that. And, I asked him directly, but he would not say.
So he wouldn't confirm nor deny that those memos exist?
I didn't ask him that way. I asked him if the documents were at the Department of Justice or if they were with him personally. And he said he did not want to comment about that in any way, shape, or form.
Will your committee subpoena those memos?
There's always a potential of using a subpoena, but we got to see how this plays out. What I do think the Department of Justice owes the House of Representatives, specifically our committee on oversight, is an explanation as to why they're not providing these documents. It isn't going to be good enough to just offer two sentences and say, hey, there's a special counsel. We're not going to let Congress do its job. We have a constitutional duty. We plan to fulfill that. If I have to send another letter tomorrow, getting them to actually more fully explain that, we will. But I would hope that the Department of Justice would do the right thing and provide us a full explanation as to why they think the Congress should not be able to see these.
Did you ask Director Comey if there were White House tapes?
I did not.
Is he upset about being fired? Could you tell based on your conversation with him?
We had a little personal interaction there that I thought we both had a smile on our face. And look, he's, in my opinion, my interaction, he's been very open, very forthright. And I appreciate him getting on the phone with us. We'll obviously have more interaction with him, at least the committee will, going forward. But I wanted to know directly whether or not he would come testify at a hearing that we were supposed to do today. And in between my email or my tweet that I put out and where we're going, basically we had a special counsel put in place, which creates a whole different equation than where we were at a week ago.
Did you get any reaction from him? Did you mention the reports that the president told the Russians he thought Comey, what was a nut job, was crazy? Did he react to that comment?
No, I didn't. I didn't spend 30 minutes on the phone. We spent a few minutes, had a very cordial call, very professional, and very accessible. And as the chairman, I do appreciate that. Nevertheless, the Congress does need to see these documents without impeding the special counsel in what they're doing. And we'll have to find our way as to what the right timing of that is. I think it's also important, even though I'm departing Congress at the end of June, that the House of Representatives continue on, because they have to provide oversight not only of this matter, but also of the special counsel. The special counsel doesn't get to continue on in perpetuity without any oversight. That's what Congress is supposed to do on both the House and the Senate. And we'll have to figure out a way to do that.
Did you talk at all about the other reports that the president asked him to shut down the entire investigation?
I did not talk to Director Comey about that. Obviously, we would like to see what's in these notes, not only to see what is the written word of Mr. Comey, supposedly, but also then eventually to talk to Mr. Comey to get his perspective on how he took it. And, you know, it's one thing to see something written down, but it's another thing to talk to somebody and say, was that threatening? Was that derogatory? Was that just said in jest? I don't know, but you'd like to get Mr. Comey's perspective. So got to see the documents, got to talk to Mr. Comey. And then let's also remember that there's another side of this story that needs to be flushed out at some point, too.
Your colleague on the House Oversight Committee, the ranking member of the Democrat Elijah Cummings, says that the fired National Security Advisor, General Flynn, made false statements about his foreign work to Pentagon investigators. Can you confirm that?
Well, what we did do a number of weeks ago is we sent to the Secretary of the Army a request for a final determination. We believe that, at least through our investigation, what we had seen, and quite frankly not seen, is that General Flynn, again, this is more than a year ago, back during the Obama administration, when he took money for appearances from the Russians and also in Turkey, that he was supposed to proactively seek permission and receive permission in order to take those payments. We see no such paperwork. And so we can't prosecute people in the House of Representatives. They don't give us handcuffs. So we refer that now back to the Department of the Army for their final determination, but that happened weeks ago.
But if he's applying to become the National Security Advisor to the president and he's filling out new forms with the Pentagon, with the Army, or whomever, shouldn't he be up front and reveal all those specific contacts he had, money he received from foreign governments?
Well, interestingly enough, the permission or the granting of a security clearance was done by the Obama administration.
But he needed additional security clearances once you're going to be the National Security Advisor.
Yes.
He may have received security clearances from the Army, from the Defense Intelligence Agency during the Obama administration. But the President Trump, wanted him to be his top National Security Advisor. That required him filling out all sorts of new forms.
And that was done, evidently, during the Obama administration. So there are a number of Obama-era relationships or Obama-era personnel. It really begs the question, why did the Obama administration approve his security clearance?
The answer is that security clearances are different than the very intense vetting, separate vetting you need to become National Security Advisor to the president. Yeah. Yes, he had security clearances. He was once the director of the Defense Intelligence Agency. Yeah. He was a three-star general. He obviously had security clearances, but you need to go through a separate round of vetting to become the National Security Advisor to the president.
Yes, and that was done in the Obama administration, administration.
President Trump said
show me
he
the
was
documents.
Going to be the
well,
National Security
think,
Advisor,
if you, he needed, if you think the answer and I, you have, well, if you think you have the answer and I don't, then share it with me, because we did participate in a classified briefing, and Mr. Cummings was sitting right at my side. So I do think I got a pretty good briefing on this, and that is really the Obama administration.
Well, you know, your colleague, Congressman Cummings, he's calling on you to subpoena those White House documents, the specific White House documents, as far as the vetting of General Flynn is concerned. Are you ready to do that?
No, I'm not. We sat through a classified briefing on this topic. I really can't say much more than that.
But why not get the documents just to double check?
I'm telling you that I've already sat through a classified briefing on this.
But why not get the documents?
Well, we can keep going back and forth. I've told you that we did sit through the classified briefing on this.
All right, but you know the documents sometimes can be not necessarily shared during a classified briefing, and sometimes the briefers don't necessarily report everything as far as the documentary evidence might provide.
Given that I was in the meeting and you were not, with all due respect, that is not something that I am going to subpoena at this moment. I'm not. We got a classified briefing on this.
All right, let's talk about something else. The Washington Post is now reporting that the former director, James Comey, may have based his decision on how to handle the Clinton email server investigation, at least in part, on a Russian document that turned out to be, quote, bad intelligence. The document may even have been completely fake. How does that report influence your understanding of the election?
Well, we haven't gotten a crystal clear picture of this. I have seen that news report, but not seeing everything that the FBI is seeing. Given that there is this ongoing investigation, I wouldn't necessarily see this. The House of Representatives is dealing with this differently than the United States Senate. In the House of Representatives, things that deal with sources, methods, intelligence, that is being done by the House Intelligence Committee. And so I would really need to leave it to that committee. As it relates to some of these other investigations, some of the stuff, for instance, with General Flynn, then the Oversight Committee has taken the lead on that. But in that particular case, in this story, really would be for the House Intelligence Committee, not for the committee that I chair.
You did play a very important role in the Clinton email investigation by publicizing Comey's letter informing you that the investigation would be reopened right before Election Day, 11 days before the election. You've been outspoken about going after leakers. Do you consider yourself, let's say, a leaker for publicizing that letter he wrote to your committee?
No, that was a non-classified a letter that was sent to lots of different people. So, no, it's unclassified information. I thought the public had the right to know. We had had a hearing in July where we had the FBI director make a commitment that if they were reopening the investigation, if they were going to spend time and resources, the director had gone to great lengths in July explaining to the American people that they were done. They weren't going to prosecute anybody. And obviously, they were now suddenly going to spend an exorbitant amount of resources looking into that investigation. So what I do like is that the Inspector General, Michael Horowitz, from the Department of Justice, he has 450 or so inspectors with him at the Department of Justice, and they're going to do a thorough look back from when Loretta Lynch met with President Bill Clinton on the tarmac all the way through, and we asked him to expand it to look through the firing of Director Comey. And that exhaustive report, because I think there's complaints legitimately on Democratic side and on the Republican side. That report, probably the first part of next year, I'm guessing they'll be complete. That will be quite a report. They're going to have to look at that as well.
Let me follow up on something you just said. Couldn't the leakers now in the White House or the Justice Department or elsewhere in the government make the same case that the public has a right to know?
No, not necessarily. It depends on the information they're dealing with. Look, when the director of the FBI sends the chairman and the ranking member and members of Congress non-classified information, yes, we have the right to make that public. Absolutely.
Well, who has the right to make it public?
Well, we do. As a member of Congress, I have the right to do that. As the chairman, I can do that. It's an unclassified piece of information.
That, when that letter came over, it was unclassified. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
And so you decided just to release it. Your committee has also requested an update from the Trump Organization on how its hotels would ensure no foreign payments end up in the president's hands. And you got a reply that it would be impractical to ask hotel guests if they're representing a foreign government. Do the current procedures go far enough to prevent any violation of what's called the Emoluments Clause?
What I find from the Trump, again, this comes more from the personal office, but what I find the Trump Organization doing is bending over backwards to be as open and transparent as possible. Now, they're going to look at the 2017 receipts, and they're figuring out a mechanism to reimburse or pay to the Treasury, if you will, when the foreign nationals stay at that hotel. That is bending over backwards. It's very early in the process, given that we're still in May. You're probably not something you're going to see until 2018. But I think they've laid out a general framework, and that will be refined over the next 7-8 months. And as you turn the corner into 2018, they will release some report at some time. And I think the Trumps are going to great lengths to be as open and transparent about this as they can possibly be.
You've got a lot going on. You're the chairman of one of the most important committees in the House of Representatives. You've got a lot of investigations going on right now. I guess it's a question that a lot of people are asking, Mr. Chairman. Why are you leaving Congress by the end of June?
No, well, you know what? At some point, you got to get off this crazy train. There's always somebody doing something stupid somewhere, so there's always plenty of things to investigate and look at. But, you know, at some point, you got to look yourself in the mirror and say, hey, I've spent more than 1,500 nights away from my family. I happen to love my wife and adore our kids. We're about to become empty nesters. And looking at the prospect of spending another 200 or 300 nights away from my wonderful wife, Julie, it's over the next 18 months. I just didn't want to do it anymore. So just want to make the transition. And I always promised that I would get in, serve, and get out. This is not supposed to be a lifetime appointment. And I don't want to get that Potomac fever and just get too caught up in myself or anything else and get more of a balance back in my life. So I decided that, hey, the end of June, we're going to hang up our cleats at this chapter of our life.
But, you know, a lot of your constituents are disappointed. You ran for a 2-year term and all of a sudden you're leaving. They're upset. And a lot of there's been a lot of speculation. You've seen all the reports that you're leaving to become what, a TV pundit? Is any of that true?
Well, I haven't felt any compulsion to talk about my post-congressional life, but I have a voice. I'd like to express it along the way, but find more balance in my life. And so we'll cross that bridge when we get to July 1st. And loosen up the tie a little bit and get more balance in my life.
Because you've seen the reports that you're heading to Fox News. Any truth to that?
Well, I'm not here to talk about that yet. We're gonna do that at the proper time. But I'm not talking about post-congressional employment at this time.
You think you'd be making the same choice if Hillary Clinton had won the presidency?
At some point, you got to say enough is enough, and you just got to keep moving on. So, look, I think I would make exactly the same choice. There's always more investigations, exciting things that we're doing. We had this great success with the Department of Education where somebody finally resigned. I think they should have been kicked out of government a long time ago. And I love the work. I really do. But I love my family more. And most people probably watching this say, oh, I don't know that I believe that. But that is the honest truth. And you know, two of our kids are now, in the last 18 months, they got married and they're moving out of state. And that's a whole new phenomenon that I didn't anticipate for 18 months beforehand.
Well, congratulations on the weddings. You've always been very generous with your time with us. We've always enjoyed having you here with us on CNN in the Situation Room. Wherever you go, we wish you only the best. And if you head to Fox, we'll miss you here on CNN.
Thank you, Wolf. We appreciate it.